Whole morning has been a little Twilight Zone-y.
Oh, da outer limit mäßig.
Okay.
Grande série, aussi angoissante, même époque, mais elle passe toujours sous silence.
Oh, I'm sorry, I don't speak geek.
Yep, stepped right in it.
I haven't seen any of like the shows dubbed into other languages yet, and I've wanted to because I just, well, first of all, for the speed alone.
I'm gonna go with a special omelet.
Okay.
With a side of bacon.
There's bacon in the omelet.
Oh, then skip the bacon.
The side of bacon?
The bacon in the omelet.
I think that one of the most difficult things to translate is, in fact, tone, and also the rhythm of speech. And I noticed that with the show, there's a real attention paid to rhythm.
Je vais goûter l'omelette spéciale avec une assiette de bacon.
Il y a du bacon dans l'omelette.
Oh, alors oublie le bacon.
It was particularly good to see that they maintained the rapid fire dialogue.
Credo proprio che prenderò l'omelette.
Okay.
Pancetta a parte.
C'è già la pancetta.
Allora niente pancetta.
I would hope that we would translate well because of just the comedy style and the energy and the sort of the slight craziness and wackiness that we have in the town. I don't know, because a lot of things we talk about are very American.
I feel like I'm on a Ricky Lake show.
Go Rory, go Rory.
In terms of the pop cultural references and how they're translated, often the translators leave the references in English.
Und um das zu feiern, wollen wir uns die Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Rocky Horror Picture Show.
They chose to not dummy down any of them wherever they could. I mean, they chose to just stick with the same level of, if the viewer gets it, they get it, and if they don't, they don't.
We can sit at either end and play bagel hockey.
Oh, bagel hockey! Jeder ein Ende und dann spielen wir bagel hockey. Oh, bagel hockey!
I understand that as the show is going to be translated into other languages, apparently there's going to be some nips and tucks.
Blasphemy.
The translators didn't focus so much on the subtleties of the cultural references. Often they simply left things out.
Which I greatly appreciate, seriously, because it's not like I didn't work really hard to put that joke in, that you could just randomly, like, just take it out.
The decisions they made about what to translate, what to leave out, what to put in, I didn't expect that it would be that kind of a matchup.
Schatz, lies unbedingt dieses Motley Crue Buch. Zu Motley Crue. Zu dem Motley Crue.
They run into trouble when they have very colloquial expressions.
What are you talking about?
An idiom, a colloquialism? Well, it's an expression that's culturally bound to whatever group is using it.
Oh, lordy. Jeez, okay. Idioms and syntax. Go ahead.
Your uniform is darling, really. I love the blue. Of course, I'm sure you look good in anything.
Oh, yeah, you should see her in chaps.
Chaps are an idiom for the United States, not an idiom for Italian. The way they translated it...
Ma sono sicura che a te sta bene tutto. Sì, dovresti vederla in frac.
Davvero?
You should have seen her in her tux, which is funny, but not as funny as you should have seen her in her chaps.
Sometimes they will just, you know, take my work and rip it apart with teeth bared and blood gushing because it works better for, you know, Italy.
We could sit in the corner, you know, the mafia table, so that no one can come up behind you and whack you with a cannoli.
Oder wir setzen uns in die Ecke an den Mafiatisch. Dann kann uns niemand aus dem Hinterhalt mit einem Grissini.
Maybe because Germans wouldn't know what a cannoli is, but they chose to use Grissini, which is a breadstick.
What are you talking about?
To stab you with a breadstick instead of whack you with a cannoli.
Are you serious?
Tu ne risques pas qu'on t'arrive dans le dos et qu'on t'attaque à coups de graissin.
They do not mention cannoli in French because I think cannoli would not be as recognizable as it is in the American context. But instead, they translate cannoli as graissin, which is a type of pâté.
No way!
The image of someone hitting someone else on the head with a graissin is slightly bizarre.
Who came up with that crazy idea?
Zili!
Oh, mon Dieu, you are gorgeous! Come, embrasse maman!
Maman, je t'ennuie!
Well, Michel is interesting because he is supposed to be Italian in the French version.
Ma cosa ci fai qui? Eravamo d'accordo che sarei venuto a prenderti all'aeroporto, birichina.
Ho anticipato la...
Now that I'm hearing things like Michelle is Italian, not French, kind of like all bets are off.
Yes, well, you know what happens when you assume.
What?
I don't know, something about a donkey. It's a stupid American phrase.
I think that the show, for a French audience, probably has a kind of exotic appeal.
I hope that they'll just, you know, get the fun of it. I hope they'll enjoy the relationship. I hope that they tap into sort of the universal unconditional love of a parent to a child, because that's got to be universal.
I'd like to go to Chateau Jean-Georges, La Jean-Georges, in Paris.
I'll look it up in Zagat in Book the Conquered.
Arrivederci e mille grazie per la vostra attenzione.
Au revoir et merci d'avoir regardé. Merci de m'avoir écouté.
Tschüss und danke fürs Zuschauen.
Welcome to France. Carver's on the house.